Alright.
Got an AC down. Not working. Let's see what's going on. Pulled the disconnect. Contactor sounds awfully loud.
You fuzzy.
Switch to continuity test, an ohm test.
Both these is good. Wiring seems okay. Maybe we haven't got a contact here. Okay. Check for voltage. At the bottom, see that 220, log speed. We got 220, and on the top, 220. We do not. We got a bad contact here.
Okay.
So, we pull the disconnect. Got a bad contact here. So again, I'm going to discharge the capacitor. Capacitor holds the charge in it, even after the power is disconnected. Let's take a look at this contactor.
All the way. So I like lost the connection.
Feel pretty good coming up the stairs on the little wheel that has a padlock holder. Anyway, here we go, check this unit. So the contactor is bad. Just going to show you from the bottom to the top, the disconnect pole we already discharged. And now it has contact. So now the unit would run now, but I'm going to change this out. Get this going. All right. So, try to position this where you get a better view. Okay. What I brought is also a new hard start kit, because that one I'm testing as good as I'd like it to. And I thought this would be able to pull the power of these. And I didn't like the way this contactor was set. I actually had considered I wanted to replace this one anyway. Discharge just for safety. There we go. Okay. So the two black ones on this side, red and the gray on the other side. Now we're going to pull, so we've got live 24 volts on the side. There we go, come on guys. There we go. And now we're ready to pull it. The desk should kick in and turn off the power for 5 minutes, 3 minutes. So long enough for us to get this changed out. There we go. Here's our new contactor. Gonna use the incoming voltage to kind of support it.
side of the contactor. Here goes the other side. Here's the insulated tool here. It should have still be on the delay, so it's good. Here's our red. That side.
On the right side.
I'm gonna tighten this up a little bit. A little tighter connection. There we go. Alright, black one. Same thing, a little tighter connection. Go. All right. Incoming voltage connected. Okay. And now our top wires. Red run wire. There we go. Okay, and now the hard start kit. Test the new one and I'll show you. Oh, the new one. Seemed a little high. Check for 24 volts on the voltage. I didn't hear it pull in, doesn't mean it didn't pull in already. It's possible that. There it is, just clicked in now. Alright, here we go. We are ready to run.
Plugging in the disconnect.
Yeah. Yay. All right. New contactor. New hard start kit. Oh boy, we're good to go.
Thank you.
We are good to go. Nice Palm Springs day. It's a hot one too. Oh boy. It's nice and cold. Alright, stay cool up there. One's ready. 2020. You gotta be ready for the Lord's return. The Lord is gonna come for his bride anytime. Jesus came to seek and to save those that were lost. That was me. We've all missed the mark. Every person sinned and come short of the glory of God. But Jesus took the punishment that we rightfully deserve on himself at the cross, and he gives his righteousness to those that believe on him. So if you haven't put your trust in him, call out to him to save you. It's a gift of salvation. You can't earn it. He did it all on the cross, and he calls us to a loving relationship with him. So you are invited to be reconciled to God, something that was impossible. God is holy and our sin separated, but without God it was impossible. But God came to save us. He sent his son Jesus. You know, again, he took all of our sin on the cross and gave himself so that we could be justified in him. So call out to him, get into the Bible, into the Word, and start to grow so that you're protected from deception. There's strong delusions out there, strong deception. And Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. He's the only way to the Father. He's the only way to God. So don't get tripped up or tricked. And don't miss out on what is yours through Jesus. So call out to him today. Don't wait. Time is short. He's going to return for his people. And if you missed it, then you find yourself in the tribulation, call out to Jesus to save you. You'll likely die for your faith, but still, like, you have eternal life. The tribulation only lasts 7 years, so if you find yourself in part of it, you know, it's not going to be long before everything's finished anyway. 7 years is not a long time, although in the tribulation it's going to seem like a long time. But be faithful unto death. That means trusting in Jesus all the way. There's probably not going to be a lot of food, and it's going to be a difficult situation, but you can still have eternal life through Jesus, because again, he took all of our sin on himself at the cross. So put your trust in him today so you don't miss out, and so that you have the covering, because he is the Lamb. The Lamb of God that takes away the sin of the world. All right, stay safe out there. God bless. God bless you. Mm-hmm.